Hello everyone, welcome to Easy Learning YouTube channel. I am Rajesh MP. Today I am going to introduce you to CBSE Class 10 Geography Chapter 1, Part 1. The name of the chapter is Resources and Development. If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, please subscribe and share it. Now we can move on to our chapter, that is Resources and Development. What is meant by resource? Everything available in our environment which can be used to satisfy our needs, provided it is technologically accessible, economically feasible, and culturally acceptable, can be termed as resources. Now we can look into the important classification of resources. It's an important question which can be expected in CBSE board exams. The resources can be classified as on the basis of its origin, that is biotic and abiotic, on the basis of its exhaustibility, that is renewable, then on the basis of its ownership, that is individual, community, national and international, and on the basis of status of development, that is potential, developed, stock and reserves. The above subject is depicted in this slide in a chart. You can go through it and sense what are the important resources that we are going to study. The types of resources. What are biotic and abiotic resources? By abiotic resources, we mean that they are obtained from biosphere and have life, such as human beings, flora and fauna, fisheries, livestock, etc. Abiotic resources are those things which are composed of non-living things. Example for the abiotic resources are rocks and metals. Now we can study about renewable resources. Renewable resources are the resources which can be renewed or reproduced by physical, chemical or mechanical process. They are known as renewable, or the other term is replenishable resources. For example, solar and wind energy, water, forests and wildlife. Now we can move to another question, that is, what is meant by non-renewable resources? They occur over a long geological time. Minerals and fossils, fuels, etc. are examples of these non-renewable resources. They take millions of years in their formation. Some of these resources, like metals, are recyclable, and some, like fossil fuels, etc., cannot be recycled and get exhausted with their use. Now we can learn about individual resources. They are owned by individuals. Many farmers of land who own the land are being allotted by the government. They plow the land and they pay revenue to the government. In villages, there are people with land ownership, but there are many who are landless. Urban people own plots, houses and other property, etc. Plantation, pasture lands, ponds, water in wells, etc. are some of the examples of resources owned by individuals. Now, continuing with the important types of resources, the other resource pertain to community-owned resources. Those resources which are accessible to all the members of the community are known as community-owned resources. The common resources of a village, for example, the grazing grounds, burial grounds, ponds, public parks, picnic spots, etc., belong to community-owned resources. What are the important national resources? That's the next question. Technically, all the resources belong to the nation. The country has legal powers to acquire even private land for the good of the public. Roads, canals, railways, etc. being constructed are owned by the individuals. urban development authorities get empowered by the government to acquire the land. All the minerals, water resources, forests, wildlife, land within the political boundaries, and oceanic area up to 12 nautical miles, that is approximately 9.2 kilometers from the coast, termed as territorial water, and resources therein belong to that particular nation. Now, we can expect another important question, that is about the international resources. There are international institutions which regulate some resources. On the basis of status of development, the important resources are potential, development resources, and stock. What do you mean by potential resource? It's an important question that we can expect in board exams. Potential resources are resources which are found in a region but have not been properly utilized. For example, the western parts of India, particularly Rajasthan and Gujarat, have enormous potential for the development of wind and solar energy, but so far they have not been developed properly. What are developed resources? The resources which are surveyed and their quality and quantity have been determined for utilization. They are called developed resources. The development of resources depends on technology and the level of their feasibility. Now we can learn about stock resources. What are stock resources? Materials in the environment which have been properly appropriate technology to access these are included among to identify at least two resources from each category. For example, water is a compound of two inflammable gases, hydrogen and oxygen, as we all know. They can be used as a rich source of energy also. What do you mean by resource planning? It's a very important portion of this chapter from exam point of view. Reserves are the subset of the stock which can be put into use with the help of existing reserves. This can be used for meeting future requirements also. River water can be used for generating hydroelectric power, but presently maybe it is being utilized only to a limited extent. Thus, the water in the dams, forests, etc. is a reserve which can be used in the future. Research planning is essential for sustainable existence of all forms of life. Sustainable existence is a component of all sustainable development. Continuing with resource planning, we can learn about the resource planning in our country, that's India. In our country, we have enormous diversity in the availability of resources. There are regions which are rich in certain types of resources but are deficient in others. While there are some regions which can be considered self-sufficient in terms of the availability of the resources, and there are some regions which have acute shortage of some vital resources. For example, the state of Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, etc. are rich in minerals and coal deposits. While the state of Arunachal Pradesh has abundance of water resources but lacks in the infrastructure development. In the case of Rajasthan, they are well endowed with solar and wind energy, but they lack in water resources. What is the resource planning? What do you mean by resource planning in our perspective, in the perspective of India? It is a complex process which involves three or four stages. The first one is the identification and inventory of resources across the regions of the country. This involves surveying, mapping, and qualitative and quantitative estimation and measurement of the resources. The second point is evolving a planning structure endowed with appropriate technology, skill, and institutional setup for implementing resource development plans. Matching the resource development plans with overall national development plans is also part of resource planning. India has made concentrated or serious efforts for achieving the goals of resource planning right from the first five-year plan, which was launched in 1951, soon after India's independence. we have come to the conclusion of this video. It's only the first part of chapter 1 of CBSE Geography. You can all expect the second part soon. Thank you all for watching my video. Please subscribe and share it with your friends. Thank you all.